everybody, and welcome to this video with myself and Alastair. And we are here to talk about the Boss RC10R Rhythm Loopstation. Not only talk about it though, Alastair is going to give us a full demonstration of how you could use it with the saxophone, and in fact, by coupling it up with the Boss GT1 unit. So we're not going to give you the full 20 minutes of spec on this because it's packed full of stuff. But Alastair, if we could just hit a couple of the main things and perhaps why somebody might consider this over just a simple single pedal unit.
Yeah, so we did a video as well on the RC3, which is kind of Boss's entry-level pedal. And this is kind of taking things up a gear a bit. One of the main features of it is it's what you call a dual-track looper. So that means kind of within one piece, you've actually got two separate tracks that you can loop up. And you'll hear that in the demo I'm going to do. So essentially, you can build one loop, then you can switch over to another track and build your other loop there. So you could kind of have an A section of your song, then build a B section of the song, and then you can switch between those sections, which obviously gives you a lot more flexibility when you're performing, so that you're not just stuck kind of in one loop over and over again. Kind of coupled with that, one of the big things they've done with this, it's really heavily based around the kind of the rhythm section of it. And you've got, I think it's over 280 different drum patterns and rhythm patterns that are in this. Mm. So you've essentially got your own drummer in the box. And there are a few really neat features of it. My favourite one is at any point during the song while you're playing, you can hit the rhythm button and the drummer will play a drum fill, which I think is a really neat little feature to have. And there are also kind of preset intro drum fills and kind of outro drum fills as well.
Imagine that, a drummer that does what you want him to do or her to do, and it's only that big, it doesn't talk back, gets there on time.
What more could a saxophonist want?
Cool, okay, so I mean, those are just some of the main features that we think are really important. There are loads of other things around it, but just check out the webpage for the full list of tech spec. But we did want to get into using it today. Just before we do Alistair's demo, Alistair, you rigged it up to the GT1. So why did you use that paired with the GT1? Yeah.
So often when you're looping up, if you're just on kind of one instrument, you have this thing where you've only got so much of the range you can play with and things can get a little bit mushy. So what I've done with the GT1, is an effect processor, and I've used an octave effect on that so that I can play in a bass line on that. The GT1 does have loads and loads of effects. It's got 100 different presets, and it's also fully customizable. It's got things like delays, reverbs, harmonizers, pitch shifters, and the octave feature that I'm using as well. So that's kind of why I've linked that up, just to add an extra element to it. So I've got the bass line coming out an octave lower.
Cool. Just one final little extra feature on this is 6 hours worth of recording you can do on this, as opposed to 3 hours on the RC3, which is the single loop station. So I think we've covered everything we want to on the specs. We know that's not absolutely everything about it, but we wanted to give you a guide for how you might, or what you could hope to get to aspirationally by using it with the saxophone. But anyway, Alistair, let's jump to you doing some playing and let's hear what you can do with this Boss unit.